Okay, good morning dear students. Today we will learn about the inverse of a matrix. In our previous lecture we already done an example of a inverse of a matrix. Now let us take another example. Suppose that we have a matrix of order 2×2. This is a matrix A, B, C and D. This is a matrix of order 2×2. Okay? In this matrix, if you want to find the inverse of the matrix, then the formula for calculating the inverse of the matrix is A inverse equal to adjoint of matrix A upon determinant of A. Okay. First, we need to find the necessary condition for a matrix. That is, the matrix is a non-singular matrix. Means this is not a numerical value, but the determinant of this matrix is, the determinant of this matrix is A into D minus B into C. And if this value is not equal to 0, then this matrix is known as non-singular matrix. Okay. In this case, we can calculate the minor of every element of this matrix. Okay, then the minor of first element is M11. It is equal to, this is the first element M11. We can hide the first row and first column, and the remaining element is the minor of the first element. Similarly, minor of B, M12, it is equal to height of second, first row and second column. Then the remaining element is C. Third is A21. Then this is the second row and first column. We can hide this and this. Then remaining element is B. And fourth is A22. Then it is equal to A. Then for finding the cofactor, and always if you want to find the cofactor, then the cofactor of cofactor matrix of this is equal to C. We can calculate the cofactor of the particular minor is equal to Cij equal to minus 1 to the power I plus j, and the minor Mij. Okay, this is the basic formula for calculating the cofactor of an element. Then this is the cofactor of this element is C11. In this place we have the I equal to 1 and j equal to 1. That is equal to minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1 and the value of the M11. Okay. So the value of this is equal to minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1. It is equal to minus 1 to the power 2. It is equal to 1. Okay. Then it is equal to 1. 1 multiplied with any element equal to the same element, then it is equal to M11. And the value of the M11 is D. This is equal to D. Okay. So the C11 equal to D. Similarly, C12 equal to minus 1 to the power 1 plus 2 and M12. Then it is equal to minus 1 to the power 1 plus 2 equal to minus 1 to the power 3. It is equal to minus 1. Okay, then this is equal to minus of M12 and this is equal to minus C. Similarly, C21, it is equal to minus 1 to the power 2 plus 1 and it is equal to minus B. 2 plus 1 M21, it is equal to minus B. Similarly, last point is C22, it is equal to minus 1 to the power 2 plus 2. And M22, then it is equal to plus 1 into M22, and it is equal to M22, and the value of M22 is A. Okay. So the, or simply we can calculate the minor of cofactor of any element or cofactor of particular element by changing the sign. The sign of this element is plus, so this is plus, this is minus, plus, minus. Okay, so the cofactor matrix is C. It is equal to, the cofactor matrix is equal to C11 is D. This is C12 is minus C. C21 is minus B, and this is the C22 is A. Okay, and if you want to find the adjoint of a matrix, then always the adjoint of a matrix is the inverse of the cofactor, is the transpose of the cofactor matrix. So the adjoint of C, it is equal to transpose of cofactor matrix. Transpose means we can replace rows into column and column into rows. Then this value is first row into first column B minus C, second row into second column minus B and A. Right? This is the B minus C, this is the minus B and A. Okay, adjoint of C equal to this. Now, the inverse of the matrix is A inverse, it is equal to adjoint is this is D minus B and minus C and A. This is the adjoint. And upon determinant of A, and determinant of A is this. Determinant of A is this A into B and minus B into C. Okay, so this is the formula for calculating the inverse of A matrix 2 into 2. Okay. Now, for example, let us take a numerical example for calculating the inverse of a matrix of 2 into 2. Suppose the example of this is, suppose A equal to 2, 3 and 5, 7. Then in this case, the determinant of this matrix is A determinant equal to 2 times 7 minus 5 times 3, it is equal to 14 minus 15, it is equal to minus 1. So this value is not equal to 0. So this is a non-singular matrix. Okay. Now the adjoint of this is the adjoint of A equal to the adjoint of A equal to this value is A, this is D. This value is A, this is D. And in this formula we can replace D, we can replace D and A and A and D. Then we can change the place of 7 and 2. This and the remaining value are changed by the negative sign. This is minus 3, this is minus 5. And the denominator we have the inverse of this, is the inverse of this, the determinant of this minus 1. And after multiplying this minus 1 inside this matrix, then it is equal to minus 7, this is 3, this is 5, and this is minus 2. We can replace all the elements by minus 1. Okay, this is the inverse of the matrix, A inverse. A inverse equal to, this is the determinant of A. Similarly, we can solve another example like A equal to 5, 6, 7, 8. Similarly, B equal to 2, 3, 1, 0. Similarly, C equal to 1, 2, and 1, 2. In the case of third matrix, the determinant of this matrix is the determinant of C equal to 0, because we have the two rows are equal. If the determinant of this matrix is 0, it means this is a singular matrix. Singular matrix. Okay. And if this is a singular matrix, then we can't find the inverse of this matrix. Okay. So, student, this is the inverse of the matrix of order 2 into 2. And in our next lecture, we will learn about another example of the inverse of a matrix. Thank you.